By the end of this video, you'll know exactly how to facilitate your next working agreement creation session with a new team or even a mature team. Creating a working agreement is a team effort, and I will give you some tips, some guidelines to ensure that everyone in the team participates towards crafting that working agreement and make it a success. An Agile team working agreement is a document essentially listing all the team norms in statements like be on time on meetings. We are always on time on meetings. This document takes all the implicit agreements that the team has and makes them explicit so that the team can work together in a healthy and safe environment. This document is used by the team on a daily basis. It should be somewhere where it's visible. Everyone in the team sees it every single day and can use it. It's a reminder to be respectful for everyone in the team, to be respectful in all behaviors in the team and all communications. So when should you create your very first working agreement with a team? Well, I would say yesterday. It's always better to create the working agreement as soon as possible. I would recommend when the team just started working together, the creation of a team, the first thing you do, create a working agreement. Because how can the team know how to communicate with each other, to work with each other, if there's no norms, there's no list of things that were agreed on? That's what working agreement is all about. So create it as soon as possible. If it's not created yet, create it right now. That's totally fine. There's some key components to an effective working agreement. First, it should be visible. It should be placed somewhere where everyone can see it. If you're going to the office, quite simple. You print it and you stick it to a wall, a wall that everyone sees. But if you're working from home remotely, that's a bit harder. But just follow the rule. Place it somewhere on an application, somewhere where people can easily access it and it's visible. You don't need to enter three passwords to access it. Second, short, extremely short. Short sentences, short memorable sentences. Three, should be a team effort to write it. If someone is on sick leave or on leave, don't write the working agreement. Everyone should be present when working, when writing, when crafting the working agreement. It's a team effort. Everyone has their say. And if there's no consensus, move on to the next point. We're going to talk about that later. Fourth, updated every 2 weeks. I recommend that the team looks at the agreement and ask the question. Every 2 weeks, is it still okay? Does it need to be updated? If it doesn't need to be updated, just move on and come back in 2 weeks. And fifth and last one, consequential. Extremely important. When someone doesn't meet something that's written in the team agreement, in the working agreement, the violation needs to be mentioned by someone. If you're using Scrum to deliver value projects, the Scrum Master usually facilitates the session. But honestly, anyone can facilitate this session. It's so easy to create a working agreement if you have a good structure. But I'm going to give you in this video, just follow exactly what I'm going to teach you for the next session. And once you get used to it, you can start adding new stuff. So number one, check in. Extremely important that you do a safety check. We are creating something as a team, crafting a working agreement. So everyone should be safe sharing in the session. And you should ask them from a scale of 1 to 5, how safe are you sharing stuff in this session? 5 being the most safe. And if average answers, average votes, at least 3. You can keep going with the session. If it's 2, the team isn't safe. You stop the session and you do one-on-one calls with everyone to understand why the team is not safe. Second, icebreaker. Everyone in the team should at least talk once in the beginning of a meeting. There's tons of popular icebreakers that you can use. Just search online for a fun one. And remember the goal of icebreaker. You start with an icebreaker because once someone talks in a meeting or a session anywhere at least once, this person is way more likely to talk again in the session. If you don't start with an icebreaker, people might feel that they are afraid. They are afraid to talk. And when you start with an icebreaker, it breaks the ice and people start talking. As simple as this. The next thing you do is ask a prompt question. If we created a working agreement right now, how would that help the team in the future? Just ask this question and wait. Be silent. Be comfortable with silence. Wait for everyone to answer and insist that everyone answers. If they can do it in a few words, that's better. But insist that everyone answers. If you're working with a large team, more than 10 people, create smaller groups, maximum 5 people. It's way easier to create an effective working agreement to get consensus when there's fewer people in the session. Communication flows way easier. If you're working at the office, take a sheet of paper, a pen, and go into separate meeting rooms. If you're working from home, remotely, you can use an application like Zoom or Microsoft Teams to create breakout sessions of maximum 5 people. Randomize it. Put people in different sessions, and you can use an application like Miro.com to capture over the working agreements remotely. Everyone can work on this board at the same time. Once the team has been split into smaller groups, set a timer, at least 15 minutes, and let them have fun creating their working agreement. You don't need to be involved in that. You can jump from one session, one breakout room to another, or if it's a physical session, from one meeting room, physical meeting room to another, just to help them, to guide them, to facilitate, to answer the questions. But you don't need to stay somewhere and help them. We should be able to work that out together. Some common questions that you can ask when crafting the working agreement is, what time should the team members be available each and every single day? Time where we need to be available. For me, it's usually from 10 to noon and from 1 to 3 in the afternoon. That's the team that decided that. So basically, you prompt the question, when should the team members be available during the day? And you let them talk. It's not your role as a facilitator or Scrum Master or anyone in the team to handle this conversation, to dominate this conversation. Nope, everyone has their say, and you ensure as a facilitator that everyone talks in the team and you help them find consensus. They can agree on anything. They just need to be responsible for what they agree on. But we're going to talk about that later. Second thing, cell phones. During team events, session, meetings, can people use their cell phones? You're using Scrum to deliver value, projects, features. When is the daily stand-up? You know the daily stand-up. We're usually the first thing in the morning that we do. Is it at 9 a.m., 10 a.m.? Let the team decide. Earphones. Key thing, not to be underestimated, when we are at the office, can people use their earphones? Because some people want to communicate with each other. Some people want to collaborate with each other. Another thing, meetings. When should we schedule meetings? Because developers, if you're working in a development team, developers want to code. Development want that focused time to code. Should we have a sort of day where there's no meetings whatsoever? Or a sort of time during the day where there's no meetings whatsoever. Let the team decide on that. Definition of ready, definition of done. Do we have an agreement for that? If you're not able to join a meeting, a session, how do you let the team know? Should you let the team know 15 minutes in the session, or should you let the team know 30 minutes prior to the session? When we are working together, maybe in sprints, if you're using Scrum, will someone in the team, with at least one person in the team, focus on increasing his skill, growth, learning new stuff so that the person can share that with the team? Or will we keep working on features endlessly? All these key things can be put in the working agreement. Once the 15 minutes timer is over, everyone gets back together. The whole team gets back together. Now, each team, small teams, will have their own, very own working agreements. Some points in their working agreements, they might have not reached the consensus. Don't worry about that. We're going to talk about that later. Now, the goal of the next step is to facilitate the session to ensure that the team is able, the whole team is able to take all the small pieces, the working agreements that they created as a small group, small groups of 5, and put it in a single document, detailed document that everyone agrees on. everyone is committed to stand by this working agreement as a team. Each point in the working agreement should be high level, not specific. So help them craft the working agreement in this way. As an example, if you're using Scrum, the daily standard, you picked 9:30 a.m. So I will be on time at 9:30 a.m. for the daily standups. Why only the daily standups? Can this be applied to each and every meetings, each and every sessions that the team have? Everyone needs to be on time in all the sessions. That's a better working agreement because it's not specific to the daily standup only. Let the team decide if it's good. For the points in the working agreement where the team couldn't find a consensus, try again. Now it's bigger groups. The whole team is together. Maybe they will be able to reach a consensus. If it still fails to reach a consensus, that's no, don't worry about it. You can try again tomorrow or in 2 weeks when you revisit the working agreement. Just remove it from the working agreement for now. For all the things that are not part of a working agreement, you should facilitate the session. The session, tons of people in the session, so the session might go in different directions. Try to keep a focus on the working agreement, on each part and everything that the team members mention that are not related to the working agreement. Just drop that down in the parking lot. We usually use a parking lot, but we can talk about that later at the end of a meeting, end of a session, or in another session. At this point, you should have a beautifully crafted working agreement on a single page. Now the most important part, the crafting was really important, but now the commitment part, that is where the thing can break if you don't have a commitment of a team. Remember, I told you from the beginning, it's the team that's crafting the working agreement, not you. You should not give your input in that. Let them decide, because the team needs to agree together on a working agreement that they will commit to following every single day, every single hour. Make them vote on each point. Read the point aloud. Read the point and make them vote yes or no on each point. If they don't agree with the point, they cannot agree with the point. If they don't agree with the point, ask the person who doesn't agree, what would change? What do we need to do as a team? What would change that no to a yes? No consensus, remove it, try again in 2 weeks. If there's consensus for each point, the team has committed to work with this working agreement. And that's it. That's it. Congratulations, you just completed your very first working agreement. If you want more tips and insights on Agile, Scrum, personal growth, click on the video that stands out the most on the screen right now. And I'll see you in a few seconds.